Hariyom Tassat. Please get ready for our practice for today, the yoga capsule, intermediate, if you have short time. This is going to be very useful for you. So again, sit in a meditation asana, make you comfortable. We always begin our session with a very short meditation. The purpose is to make you calm, peaceful before we begin our yoga sadhana. Let the body to become comfortable while you sit it in meditation asana. Close your eyes. Be aware of your whole body. Sit it in dhyan mudra, in a state of meditation. That includes your body. That includes your mudra of the hand and awareness. Let your awareness to get internalized and make it one pointed at the eyebrow center. As you focus at the eyebrow center, we will chant Om three times. Take a deep breath in. Om. Feel the vibrant body after the invocation of Om mantra within. Feel the positivity, calmness and peace healing all around you. And carry that awareness for the yoga sadhana now. Gently open your eyes. And please come to standing pose. We'll begin our journey with the three practice first as a preparation, as a warm-up. And the first practice that we will do is Tadasana, palm tree pose. Hold your hand up over the head. Make your eyes one-pointed. Concentrate at a point which is little above your eye level, and breathing in, stretch your arms fully up. Make you long and tall. And while you breathe out, very gently come down. Breathe in, two. Breathe out, two. Breathe in, three. Breathe out, three. Breathe in, four. Breathe out, four. Breathe in, five. Breathe out, five. And continue for five more rounds. You must account your practice. Counting the number of round itself is a very important point of concentration. So you must maintain that, the quality of your awareness. Focused eyes. Ten rounds to do and feel the lengthening up of the spine. We are going to do the sequence of three practice, Tadasana, Triyaka Tadasana and Kati Chakrasana. And the practice is lengthening up the whole body. and we'll carry that into lateral bending and the twist as well. TTK is not only the part of yoga class, but they are also the important for the morning time. Hold your hand up over the head for the second practice, Triyaka Tadasana. Arms to be straight. Be aware of your waist part that you are going to use now. Breathe in, arms straight. Breathe out, bend to the right. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, left. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, right. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, left. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, right. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, left. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, right. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, left. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, right. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, left. Fifth round. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, right. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, left. Carry on for 5 more rounds. Keep relaxing your body while you move into it. Be aware of the lateral bending of the spine, the side stretch of the muscles. It is unique practice. The side you bend, that side muscles get contracted and other side muscles get stretched. Activation of digestive organs, improving the respiratory muscles. In general, this is a very important practice, the part of TTK sadhana. After Tadasana, this should be done, Triyaka Tadasana. Not only in the classroom to begin your yoga session or end your yoga session, but they are the part of lifestyle. When you get up in the morning, you must have water and then do TTK sadhana as the first action. Anything is done by you. Now Kati Chakrasana, maintain the same gap, raise your hand at shoulder line. It's a waist part movement, so hip thigh should not be part of the practice. Twist your right, keeping your hip, thigh and knee relaxed. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, left. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, right. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, left. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, right. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, left. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, right. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, left. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, right. Breathe in, center. Breathe out, left. You carry on. We'll do total of 10 rounds. In TTK sadhana, this is the third practice. Such a beautiful combination of three practices to improve quality of your spine. Any time in the day you can do it, but this should be the first action of your day. When you get up, have some water and do TTK to improve the quality of the body, to prevent injury, to improve the peristalsis movement of the intestine, to get proper cleansing. After completing the TTK, we will do the next practice, that is Surya Namaskar. 6 rounds. You need to come to front of your place. Keep your feet together and carry the awareness that you have achieved after the TTK practice. Be aware of the quality of the body, the balance, the awareness. Mood has been boosted after TTK. Right in front of you, visualize the rising sun. Connect with the Surya, the rising sun. Bring your hands to Pranamudra, prayer pose. Bring the image of Surya in your heart. And as you bring the awareness of Surya in your heart, open the eyes. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Padhast. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Parvat Asan. Hold the breath Stanga. Breathe in Bhujang. Breathe out Parvat. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Parvatasan. Hold the breath Stanga. Breathe in Bhujang. Breathe out Parvat. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Parvatasan. Hold the breath Stanga. Breathe in Bhujang. Breathe out Parvat. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Parvatasan. Hold the breath Stanga. Breathe in Bhujang. Breathe out Parvat. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Pranam. Third round. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Parvatasan. Hold the breath Stanga. Breathe in Bhujang. Breathe out Parvat. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Parvat Asan. Hold the breath Stanga. Breathe in Bhujang. Breathe out Parvat. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Parvatasan. Hold the breath Stanga. Breathe in Bhujang. Breathe out Parvat. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Parvat Asan. Hold the breath Stanga. Breathe in Bhujang. Breathe out Parvat. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Parvatasan. Hold the breath Stanga. Breathe in Bhujang. Breathe out Parvat. Breathe in Asva Sanchalan. Breathe out Padahast. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe out Pranam. Breathe in Hastuttan. Breathe out Padahast, breathe in. Asvasanchalam, breathe out. Parvatasana, hold the breath. Stanga, breathe in. Bhujang, breathe out. Parvat, breathe in. Asvasanchalam, breathe out. Padahast, breathe in. Hastuttana, breathe out. Pranam, last round, sixth round, breathe out. Pranam, breathe in. Hastuttana, breathe out. Padahast, breathe in. Asvasanchalam, breathe out. Parvatasana, hold the breath. Stanga, breathe in. Bhujang, breathe out. Parvat, breathe in. Asvasanchalam, breathe out. Padahast, breathe in. Hastuttana, breathe out. Pranam, breathe out. Pranam, breathe in. Hastuttana, breathe out. Padahast, breathe in. Asvasanchalam, Parvatasana, Stanga, Bhujang, Parvat, Asvasanchalam, Padahast, Hastuttana, and Pranam. Close your eyes. Be aware of your yatra so far. We are in yoga capsule sadhana, in short duration, letting the body to be ready. For those who has sought time to do practice yoga sadhana, they may choose this series. We are going to do next is a balancing asana, Eka Pada Pranamasana. It is an act of balance. Balancing represents firmness, steadiness, and the strength. Be aware of your feet and equalize the energy and balance on both. We'll begin with the left foot down first. Switch your weight on the left foot. Look at a point, open the eyes. At the same time, you can see yourself and then fix your right leg up. Let the right heel to come close to the base of the body. And once you achieve the balance, bring your hands to Pranam Mudra right in front of you. Continue with the posture. I'll count for you 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Very systematically release the posture. Make you comfortable before you do other side. And we'll do same 20 count holding to the other side. Get balanced, comfortable. Hold it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Relax yourself. We are going to do the last two asana, that is Paschimottanasana, followed by Sarvanga Asana, the highly recommended practice by Swami Sivananda. For those who have very short time to do yoga sadhana, he recommended to do these two practice to get overall effect, not only physical, mental, but also spiritual benefit. Sit down with outstretched leg. Turn your ankle towards you. Rest your hand on your thigh. Breathing in, raise your hand up above your head and get stretched nicely. And then very gently bend you forward. Try and reach the toe, keeping the back straight, that is for sure. Maintain a straight back, looking front. Slowly start bending forward. Remember, when you bend forward, don't use the waist part, it is the hips, hamstring, ankle towards you. Keep your torso active. And if you notice the abdominal muscles, the rectus abdomini is going inside. Once you reach a comfortable point, which is not painful, you are comfortable, retain the posture and close your eyes. Mentally relax your whole body, being in Paschimottanasana. Paschima means the back, Tan means to stretch the back. In a spiritual term, Paschima represents Susumna Nadi, and the word Tan has come from Tantra. It means expanding your consciousness and prana in the Susumna Nadi is the practice of Paschimottanasana. Breathe and relax yourself, being your whole body in Paschimottanasana, making you relaxed. Keep relaxing yourself in the posture Paschimottanasana. And now we will come out of the posture. Very gently raise your hand up, get stretched, get the element of the Tadasana, so that any compression which is not good will go. And now lie down in Savasana. Before we do Sarvanga Asana, as a counterpose of Paschimottanasana, and preparation before Sarvangasana, will do Kandharasana, bend both your knee. Hold your ankle from the back side. Very gently breathe in, lift your buttocks up off the floor. Be aware of your head and shoulder. Keep it on the ground. Be aware of shoulder blades, join them. And allow your chest to touch the chin. This is called Kandharasana. It is good for those with the lower back pain. It prevents problem of hernia, improve your breathing, your respiratory muscles. Keep relaxing in this posture. If you feel Sarvanga Asana is not a possible asana for you at the moment, you may continue with this posture. Otherwise, you may lower the body down and raise the leg, roll your back, or you can do a trick. Rest your back on your hand and then you can raise one by one into Sarvanga Asana. You can go any way, but easy way you have to go. So, adjust your body and position, raise your leg, gently roll your back up off the ground. In Sarvangasana, the body should become fully perpendicular and there is extreme pressure on your neck. But if you are not comfortable, you are always allowed to have adjustment. The comfort is more important here. Simply relax and hold yourself, being in Sarvanga Asana. Sarvang means all body parts, Sarva Anga. And why it is known as Sarvangasana? Because of its special relation with thyroid gland, which takes care of the most of your body function. Be aware of the altered state of your body. Be aware of the altered state of your mind. Keep relaxing. And not only the altered state of body and mind are there, but also the pranic flow in your body. Now very gently bend your knee and the lower the knee towards your forehead first. Ease out your back. And then drop your hand to get support to the whole body. And vertebra by vertebra, just try and lower yourself down to the floor. We are going to do the next practice in a moment. Saral Matsyasana or Matsyasana. Saral Matsyasana means you will keep your both legs straight and together, and then you will lift upper body and you will arch your spine and put your crown on the floor. Or you can do Padmasana first, being in Savasana, and then with the help of palm and elbow you will lift your head and chest first up, and then you will turn your head down and you will put the crown on the floor. So you may either choose Saral Matsyasana, easy fist pose, or go to the fist pose if you can do Padmasana. Elbow down to help you to take the load of the practice. You must put the elbow down. And if possible, put your palm on your thigh and relax in the posture called Matsyasana, the fist pose. Keep relaxing and breathing, being in Matsyasana, fist pose. Now very gently come out of the posture. Relax yourself for a moment in Savasana, leg apart, hands away, palm facing up, fingers naturally curled, and keep your eyes closed. Relax your heartbeat, breath rate. Be aware of yoga practices that has been done by you now. With every moment, every breath, it makes you feel better and better, relaxed. Mentally scan your body. Breathe in from the toe to head. Breathe out, head down to the toe. Mentally rotate your awareness from the toe to head while you breathe in. Head to the toe while you breathe out. With every moment you become more and more better, comfortable and relaxed here, notice that. We are in Yoga Capsule doing our practices short time, but we are not compromising with the quality of the practice. Doing in short time doesn't mean you do the practices fast. Technically you should be always right. Here we are only being selective with the practices so that you can accommodate your practice in short time. We are going to do the last practice in our this sadhana, that is Nadi Sodhan Pranayam, 1:1:1. While holding the breath in Antar Kumbhak, we will do Jalandhar and Moolbandh as well. So make your body move. Get nicely stretched and in your own time sit down. Sit in a comfortable meditative asana. You must sit upright and straight. Sit properly. Make you comfortable, meditative, upright and still. Breathe yogically. Breathe slow and deep. Using the yogic breath technique, while you inhale, expand your abdomen, then chest. And then exhale, chest empty, then abdomen. Having the slow and deep full breath. And bring your hand into action. Nasagra Mudra. Either use right or left hand, doesn't matter. You can use any of the hand. Two fingers to go at eyebrow center. In case of right hand, thumb at right nostril, ring finger at left and little free. Start with the left nostril. Breathe in left. Then you hold the breath by closing both the nostrils. Breathe out right. Breathe in right, hold, breathe out left. While holding the breath, do Jalandhar Bandh. It is very simple. No need to drop the hand down. You just bend your head down, touch the chin to chest. If you know the Mool Bandh, then contract the bottom part of your body. In male, this area is known as perineum, and in female, cervix. If you don't know Mool Bandh, then just be contained with the throat lock. It is very simple. Hold the breath inside, bend your head down and touch your chin to the chest very softly, considering your neck comfort. And when you feel to breathe out, your head will come back up and you will breathe out through the other nostril. So it's very simple. Left in, hold, right out. Right in, hold, left out. Known as Nadi Sodhan Pranayam. Focus should be your eyebrow center. It is very simple. Left to breathe in, then to hold, right to breathe out, right to breathe in, then hold, then left to breathe out. While holding the breath, do Jalandhar and Moolbandh, and remember 1:1:1 means the count you take for inhalation, same count you retain the breath, same count to exhale. equal ratio of inhalation, inner retention and exhalation. Focus should be the eyebrow center. Considering this as your last round for today, once you are completed with the left nostril breathe out, that concludes the round and you lower the hand. Continue with the awareness of eyebrow center. Be aware of your yogi yatra that you have just completed now as a yoga capsule to complete your sadhana in short duration. Visualize a light at eyebrow center. We'll chant Om 3 times. Breathe in. Hari Om Tat Sat.